Happy Tuesday, ADOM Nation, and welcome to another featured company live cast. I'm your host, John Stamper, and love these, right? Like we always talk about when we get the opportunity to do these, there are so many great companies in our dental profession that are creating technologies, but more importantly, they're providing solutions to help you make your day better, right? More efficient and all of that. So very excited to have Al. He gave me permission to just call him Al Uddin, who's the CEO of NexHealth with us. How you doing, Al?
I'm doing well. Thank you for having me, John.
You got it. All right. So before we get started, I did want to read this. Super impressive. This guy's doing a lot of work and building a massive team to help support our dental industry. So NexHealth is the complete patient experience solution for small, medium, and large dental practices. Al was selected to appear in the 2018 edition of Forbes 30 Under 30 and has managed a team to grow NexHealth to 25,000 plus healthcare providers in 3 years. So safe to say, Al, you got some things going on. A little busy?
Yeah, no, a lot of exciting things have happened over the last couple of years, especially, you know, the last 12 months with the pandemic and all. Yeah,
awesome. All right, well, so let's dig into what we're going to do, everybody, like we always do. We'd love to have you show Al a little bit of love. Let him know where you're watching from across the country today. We're going to have a conversation and learn about this great company, NexHealth. So, Al, I thought I'd get started in regards to have you share how NexHealth is helping currently and the plans to, in the future, help the dental industry.
Yeah, definitely. I think, given the audience here, I think that the biggest takeaway should be that NexHealth as a company, what we're really focused on is having great integrations with whatever dental system you may be using. So for example, you know, you could be using Denticon, you could be using Dentrix, Open Dental, EagleSoft, whatever it is, right? So, you know, we have this, you know, really great in-house proprietary technology that we built that's able to synchronize data back and forth, you know, between whatever dental software you're using and NexHealth every 30 seconds or so, right? So that means, you know, we can create new patients automatically, we can read new patients automatically, all of it done seamlessly automatically. The reason I emphasize that is that, you know, for an office manager, for example, right? You know, let's say, I don't know, like you're using this online scheduling system. And if the online scheduling system that you're buying or the patient communication system that you're buying, the new patient paperwork system that you're buying, if that system, you know, you bring it in, yeah, you want to give your patients a good experience. But ultimately, you know, if it creates more work for you to maintain that system, then it sort of like defeats the point of having a system, right? Like, you know, yeah, sure, you're buying like, I don't know, it's a new patient paperwork or an online scheduling system, you set it up. And then, you know, all of a sudden you have to monitor 24/7, you have to customize it, you have to like, you know, take information and then like type it into your Dentrix, right? That creates a lot of work. So you know, like we help our customers with this all-in-one solution that's able to digitize your entire patient experience and entire front desk, from online scheduling to online payments to new patient paperwork to reviews, reminders, recalls, all of it in one place, right? And that's great. Like a lot of people do that stuff, right? But I think, you know, like where we really stand out and where we really differentiate ourselves is that our integration with whatever system you may be using is real time. It's customizable, it's very flexible, and it's so good that it acts like and mimics like as if the, you know, you as an office manager is, you know, putting that patient into the system, or you as a receptionist is putting that patient into that system. So basically, you know, my point is, you know, we do a lot as a company. We fully digitize the end-to-end patient experience, but we really, you know, from a technology standpoint, tend to focus on that integration so much that there's really no hiccups for you as an office manager. And we, you know, the automated system we have, the automated synchronizer we have, it's so customizable. It's so reliable that, you know, it literally acts as if the, you know, you have a receptionist 24/7 putting data into your Dentrix, into your EagleSoft, whatever system you may be using. Yeah.
Yeah, I love that. I know one of the things you mentioned, patient experience, which I'm sure you're very passionate about. And we talk about that a lot here on this ADOM Facebook page, on how the patient experience has changed dramatically. As you know, Al, there are so many different technologies we all use as consumers in order to be able to make that patient experience more seamless. And now that expectation is also falling upon the dental practice, right? Patients are coming in and they have that same expectation. They want those tools to be available to themselves, you know, for their patient visit and things like that. So I'd love to have you share with everybody your passion for the patient experience and how all this came about as far as putting all this together.
Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, like obviously as consumers, all of us as consumers, you know, we consume healthcare, we consume dentistry, and you know, as a consumer, I want to have a great experience, right? But more importantly, you know, there's two things that are, I think, you know, that's unique about the experience behind founding the company. One is that you know, we're based out of San Francisco. Like I'm literally sitting in our office right now in FIDI, you know, where this city really, you know, Silicon Valley in general, right, has come in and transformed every facet of our lives today, right? You know, you can get food delivery instantaneously. You can get your groceries delivered instantaneously. You can watch a movie anytime you want, right? And one of the things, you know, that I noticed when I was working as a receptionist as an undergrad at a doctor's office in the Bronx. So, you know, the background of the company is that, you know, I was working as a receptionist in the Bronx in New York, just making phone calls really for the doctor part-time as an undergrad. And one of the things I noticed is that the experience that we were offering patients, and at that time I'm 20 or 21 or something, you know, the experience we're giving our patients, it's very manual. You know, it's, you know, hey, here's like a stack of paper, fill it out, give me a call if you want to book an appointment. And then on top of that, as a receptionist, I had to make a ton of phone calls to try to, you know, remind patients about their appointments and have them come back into the office. And, you know, we were using ZocDoc, we were using DemandForce, even though we were using all those different systems, I still had to, like, you know, do a lot of manual data entry to keep, you know, my Dentrix, my system of record, and all these different systems, like, fully synchronized and actually fully working. And it would still result in this, like, really bad patient experience, right? So anyways, like, going back to the context, right, you know, like, over the last couple of years, Silicon Valley has come in and as consumers totally transformed the experience that we have everywhere else, right? Like, I bought a, you know, Tesla recently. And as long as, you know, it's a fascinating experience, as long as I have my phone in my pocket, I don't have to use a key. I just get in, I press the brake, and I drive. Like, it's the smoothest thing you can experience, right? So anyways, so there's this, like, huge disconnect between the experience we give our patients in the dental offices, you know, having them fill out paperwork, make phone calls for appointments, versus, like, what, you know, what as an everyday consumer I face and I experience everywhere else, right? And it's jarring, right? Like, going from this, like, really convenient, you know, in my phone automated experience when it comes to my food, my grocery delivery, my car, everything, to then going into a dental office and having to fill out, you know, paperwork through, like, an actual paper, it's just not a good experience. So anyways, so being young, being, you know, also working at a doctor's office, also being, you know, like, into technology, self-taught, all of that, I think, you know, combined into this need, or this desire that I had of, like, fully end-to-end digitizing the whole patient experience, but also making sure that I, as a receptionist, don't have to do any work to make the system work. So, you know, right, we really focus on the end so that, you know, it saves me time, saves the patient's time, and it's overall good for everyone. Yeah.
Yeah, and there's a lot of things, as you know, I mean, you've done it, you've sat in that chair, that when you do create that space and you do create that time for the team up front, there certainly are other things that they can do. And in a lot of cases, as you know, Al, it's providing maybe more communication with the patient, like being there and being able to be present with the patient and not feeling like they're, you know, running all over the place and they can't really give that patient experience, which I love. And, you know, one of the questions I wanted to ask you as well is, there's a lot of practices, as you know, they got live chat, you know, they do this manual appointment booking like you talked about. So for the offices that have that, can you share with everybody still the value of using the online booking system, even though these are some of the tools they've used for a while, and the real value of where it helps them?
Yeah. I think, you know, if you're an office manager, like, one of your jobs in addition to, or really, you know, if you're any member of the staff, right, like, one of your jobs in addition to making sure that patients show up and they have a good experience is also to ensure, you know, do things that grow the business, right? And often, you know, saving time, and often, you know, giving patients a good experience, from my experience at least, do contradict sometimes with the growth of the business as a business, right? So the way that we've designed our online scheduling and the technology behind it, we've designed it in a way that, you know, where those two worlds, me and as a receptionist or as an office manager, saving time, giving my patients a good experience, while at the same time making sure that, you know, we have top of funnel growth when it comes to new patient acquisition, right? So one of the things, you know, we've done basically is that, you know, we built this online scheduling tool that's fully customizable, that you can, you know, log into NexHealth. You'll have a rep that will assign to you, a technical rep that will assign to you, that'll work with you, fully customize every single facet of the workflow. So meaning like, you know, the type of appointment you want to offer your patients, you can build that custom. The hours that you want to make available, you can build that custom, right? So you can say, hey, I want to offer new patient exam and cleaning between the hours of 2 to 5 in operatory 3 and only on Wednesdays once a month. And I want to make that available only for hygienists, and I want to make that available for only Aetna patients. And before the patient books an appointment, I want to make sure that they give me a credit card. I want to make sure that they give me their, you know, insurance ID. And I want to make sure that they answer, you know, their COVID questionnaire before they can book an appointment. All those things that you can build through NexHealth, right? And then all those questions, all those customization, all the data we're collecting from the patient, then we can take that information and then automatically upload it within 30 seconds into your Dentrix, into your Open Dental, your EagleSoft, whatever system you're using, right? So not only, you know, do you get to collect all the information as a receptionist would before the patient books an appointment, but it also gets put into your system, whatever system you're using, automatically without any input from any human being, right? It's all automated, it all works, it's just accurate. And imagine that customization, that page, that workflow, all of it, you take that and you make it available on your Instagram page, your Facebook page, your Google page, your website, right? So that as a patient, as a modern patient, I can discover you and I can find you, your practice, wherever, however, right? So do I not only have a good experience as a patient, but also as an office manager, as a receptionist, as office staff, you also have a great experience where you save, you know, at least at a minimum, 5 to 10 minutes per patient. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And as you know, like these, so many of these technologies, you know, they're designed in, you know, with the patient in mind, but like you mentioned, it's creating time and space and efficiencies for the team. And one of the things that's really exciting that I see with some of these new technologies is it's providing, for example, a company like NexHealth to be able to see what's actually happening with all of your customers. And so with that comes data that you're able to, I would imagine, in a lot of cases, give back to practices. To, for example, one of the things I wanted to ask you is about patient retention. So with the data that you have and pulling all this stuff together, can you share maybe a tip with the audience of what you guys have seen at NexHealth in regards to maybe some ideas of what really helps with patient retention?
That's a great question. And honestly, the answer is really simple. Here's an interesting stat for you, which is that over 73% of the appointments that are scheduled from existing patients through our system, it's done after hours. Meaning, you know, 73% of the appointments that are being scheduled from existing patients, it's being done after 6 p.m., right? Mm-hmm. So here's the scenario, right? If I'm an existing patient, you know, I came in for a cleaning maybe 6 months ago, and it's, you know, now it's time for my cleaning again, right? You already have me as a patient. You already have me in your office. I already know the doctor. I love the doctor. I love the office staff. You don't have to do anything to convince me to come back. You know, if I'm an adult, a responsible patient, there's a very high chance that, you know, I want to, at a minimum, every year, I want to get a cleaning, right? And one of the things that, you know, we noticed in today's age, where, you know, 98% of people, they open their text messages, right? So, you know, you'll use other solutions out there, like Solution Reach or Lighthouse or whatever, right? And you can send the patients a text message, your existing patient at least, you know, for a recall, for a reminder, for, you know, birthday messages, whatever it is that you're doing, right? You send them a text message. And 98% of those people, they actually open their text message and they read that text message. But what ends up happening is that no one actually takes action off of that text message. No one picks up the phone and calls you. No one fills out that form, right? So yeah, you're sending those text messages. You're basically wasting money doing that, because even though 98% of those patients are opening that text message and actually reading it, they're not taking any action off of it, right? So one of the key insights that we had was that, hey, what if we had an online scheduling link or a button in the email or the text message that you can just embed into the text message. And then as a patient, I can click on it. I can pick, you know, tomorrow 2 p.m. And I, you know, we already know it's you, it's your phone number, right? And then I can just, you know, with two taps, book an appointment right then and there, and then show up the next day, right? So making that process of scheduling an appointment, once the patient opens that text message, which by the way, 98% do, and making that frictionless, especially after hours, because, you know, most people, they have a day-to-day job. especially if they're going to their dentist, right? They have a day-to-day job and they do personal things after hours. So if you can make that available and frictionless after 6 p.m. through their text message or through their email, they're more likely to take an action on that text message, which means, you know, typically means just like booking an appointment. And like I said, 73% of scheduling that comes through our system is after hours. So anyways, my point is like,
yeah,
you know, As a dental office, you're in the business of providing something that every single human being in the world needs. And the best thing you could be doing is making it as easy as possible for your patients to come back and see you, which means, you know, giving your patients the systems and the tools and the convenience that they're used to in their daily life. And one of those things is online scheduling. Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. And I love that stat and I'm glad you shared it because as you know, Al, the schedule in a dental practice is usually one of the most sacred things, right? I mean, when you look at, when you look at the ability for a practice to be able to control that, manage it, fill the blocks where they want to fill it and, you know, and things like that. And to hear that statistic that over 70% of patients are not scheduling their appointments till after hours anyways, when most people are not in the practice, is very, very telling. And I think it's exciting about with some of the work that you guys are doing. Okay, so another question, just got learned a little bit as I've been kind of learning about what you guys do, that NexHealth recently acquired, is it NLive Forms? Did I say that right?
NLive Forms, yep.
NLive Forms, it would have you. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, you know, so one of the things, like my vision, at least, you know, when starting the company is that I wanted to build a system that would fully automate the patient experience so that, you know, me, the front desk person, I don't have to do anything to get the patient in or actually see them, right? It's like that it's all automated. It's all taken care of by the patient, right? So before this NLive acquisition, you know, we had online scheduling fully automated. We had online payments fully automated. We had reminders, communication, messaging, reviews, recalls, all of it fully automated. The key piece that we were missing was forms. And new patient paperwork, meaning, you know, forms, digitized forms that actually works, meaning, you know, you can fully customize it exactly the way you want. And then all the fields, you know, once the patient fills it out, it then pre-populates into Dentrix or EagleSoft or whatever you want without any sort of manual input. So anyways, we started working and partnering with this company called NLive, you know, found in, they're out of California. And we have mutual customers. Their customers absolutely love the product, absolutely love the solution, and, you know, relied on it on a daily basis. And we looked at a few others as well. There's, you know, lots of players out there doing new patient paperwork. And we realized that, you know, the NLive team has the best customer support you can get, the best technical support you can get. And the product, you know, it's so simple and easy to use, but it's so complex on the back end that it just works. So anyways, yeah, we decided to, you know, partner up and then eventually buy the whole company so that we can plug it into our existing solution and then fully automate and fully digitize the patient experience and be, you know, truly able to say like, hey, NexHealth is end-to-end, meaning, you know, from a patient finding on Google to scheduling an appointment, all the way to, you know, filling out their patient paperwork before they actually come into the office. And of course, you know, like now, you know, before maybe we saved you 10, 15 minutes per patient. And now I think we can say, you know, we'd save you 30 minutes per patient. Yeah.
Yeah. That's big. That's really big, as you know. How about any other exciting news, you know, being here on the Adam Facebook page, any other exciting things going at NexHealth that you'd love to share with the Adam audience?
Yeah. You know, recently we started, you know, earlier I emphasized that the in-house technology we built that's able to synchronize with, you know, any sort of dental system, 30 seconds, really reliably, right? Recently we started opening up that technology to other technology providers, right? So think about companies like, Smile Direct Club or companies like Quip, companies like TrueLark, some of these names you might have heard of, some of them you haven't heard of, but these are services that you may already be using in your office or these are services that, you know, you will be using soon. And the interesting thing and the really exciting thing about that is that the real-time synchronization technology that we built that saves office managers so much time is, you know, soon going to be available to all the other vendors that you may be using in your office, right? So for example, you know, whenever we work with a customer, they're already using two or three other vendors for lots of different services. Maybe, you know, some we compete with, maybe some we don't, like a VoIP phone service, for example. It could be like a ZocDoc or like a, you know, some other solution out there. And the cool part is that you bring us in, you know, we'll give you online scheduling forms, patient communication, et cetera. And, you know, we'll make sure that the synchronization between your dental system and NexHealth is fully automated. It works, it, you know, reads and writes data every 30 seconds. And we can now take that one step further and make sure that all the other systems you may be using in the office is also then fully integrated and fully synchronized with, you know, Eaglesoft, Dentrix, and whatever other system you may be using. My point is, you know, like, we want to make sure that you as office staff have to do as little data entry, as little manual work as possible. And we know that we can't build all the features out there. So we're starting to partner up with other companies to provide you with some of those features as well. Yeah.
Yeah, that's exciting, right? Staying in your lane. But like you mentioned, when we kind of started live here, that you had an explosion in dentistry of all these new technology solutions. And so practices want to get their hands on a lot of them. But like you mentioned, if you end up doing more manual work, even other technology solutions, you're going to lose that time. So being able to stay in your lane, connect and sync up with those other applications, super cool. Love it.
Yeah. And, you know, we have this philosophy internally when we develop products that, you know, we want to do a few things and we want to do it really, really well. You know, we're never going to try to claim to do all the things in the world. So anyways, we opened up our technology to other players, and we're not partnering up with a bunch of different companies out there. We're going to announce them soon as well. But my point is, you know, like, if you use NexHealth, if you buy NexHealth, you can be assured that it's the future, that, you know, like, you can rely on us for the next 10 plus years at a minimum. Yeah.
Super exciting. All right. So Al, where can our audience learn more about NexHealth, get more information about a lot of these great things you talked about today?
Yeah, if you honestly just go to our website, I think that's the best way to reach us, nexhealth.com. So that's N-E-X, health like healthcare.com. There's a demo button. You can click on it. And once you do, fill out your information, and then one of us will reach out to you right away within 10 minutes. And then, you know, happy to walk you through a live demo of the solution. And, you know, just to emphasize how important it is to actually see a demo, over 60% of dentists that actually see a demo ends up buying our product. So you really got to see it to believe it. Yeah.
I love that. So, you know, the ADOM conference is coming up very soon here in September. Everybody's really, really excited about that. And again, for those of you that have not had an opportunity to be able to register yet, ADOMconference.com, be sure to go check it out. I don't know, Al, you and your team going to be in Orlando? Is that at the conference this year?
Yeah, I think so. I don't know what booth number we are, but we'll definitely be there.
Sweet. Yeah. All right. Well, we're looking forward to meeting you in person. Congrats again on your success and everything that you and your team are doing to make dentistry more efficient. We really appreciate it. The ADOM team appreciates you guys, and we'll see you in Orlando.
Yeah. Awesome. Thanks so much for having me, John.
All right. You got it. Thanks, Al.
Bye-bye.